Has been going on today. Can you continue with strings? You must understand why Roland says she plays strings by now. As far as I'm concerned, any spiritual man that doesn't understand the language of music is devoid of understanding of spiritual technicalities. You'll be limited in the realm of the spirit if you don't understand how sound works. Sound is the tool of creation. Prophetic work with sounds, the apostolic work with sound, doctrine and guardianship. I don't understand this microphone. It's guided by sounds. You cannot come and play just like that. You need to understand the language and the impartation. Because it is the tool of creation. Bible says when God was creating, the morning stars were singing unto creation. Department was orchestrated in heaven that Lucifer occupied so that sound can be put in place, so that when you pray, answer can be sent from heaven. And that's why every prayer person must understand worship. Every worshiper must understand prayer. The link that connects them is the creativity of it. The prophetic meet in a junction with the apostolic by sounds. If you are a prophetic person, you must have songs that has not been written by Frank Edward. If you are an apostolic person, you must have songs that has not been written by Sinach. Nobody have to understand it, but you understand it. He said, bring me a mystery, and as the mystery came, suddenly there was a voice. prophetic is likened unto a stream. It flows better with sound. And one that we are found acquainted with is the streams. You see, there is so much that is going on in the body of Christ that is not important. You may not believe me, but after you have lingered for so long, after 5 years, after 7 years, after 10 years, you look for God. And even if you are anointed, you will be the story of a man that was once upon a time anointed. We are looking for men that can remain for so long. It took me time to realize that God is not interested in you starting. Anybody can start. Few remain. In the last days, you will only be awarded for your ability to conquer territories, your ability to survive the odd. Don't tell me that somebody seduced you to falling. Don't tell me that the patterns were too much. Don't tell me that the causes were there. Roland had cause in his family. You don't have an excuse. What I'm saying is, you don't have an escape plan. So you better learn the pattern and the pathway on how to survive this. If not, you will keep learning and learning. And you'll be like a stranger that doesn't know the way to the city. You wander. Son submits to the protocol so that they can be equipped and educated. I see a calling of God upon your life. You are too quiet. But I see an apostolic call upon you. You are told not to lay hands. The Lord will empower your hand. You will lay many. It was a season of equipping and building. It was a time when the Lord had to peg you down. You are moving beyond the limit that God is taking you. And I saw the Lord have to restrain you. But I said, Lord, say when that dealing is over, He will launch you out according to His timeline. You will function in revelatory gift of the apostolic and you establish doctrine. No, I'm not telling you. You know. Okay. I want you to appreciate Prophet Roland. He is a prophet. You know, the apostolic walk by intuition, perceptions. I don't see many times. I will teach you the pattern of the voice of God. But maybe tomorrow I may add up to courses and patterns. Do you know that courses are initiated by prayer? Let me just read the dictionary definition for you so that you understand that everybody has a cause. Everybody has, even Jesus Christ, the lineage he was born, there was a cause. You wonder why he prayed the way he prayed. Oh my. If you have a dictionary, help yourself and check courses. So much words are lingering. If we have allowed Roland, he will fly. I assure you. Even if he has not spoken to you, you must understand that the Bible said that God will do nothing except reveal a secret to his servant, the prophet. Paul was the one that urged us that at least we should desire minimum among spiritual gifting that we prophesy. Because if you lack the ability of the prophetic, your limitation has no end. When I see people that fight the prophetic, I don't argue with them. I let them be. One day they will need it. There are two offices that you should never fight. Even if you don't understand, the apostolic and the prophetic. Let it be. God started with it, He's going to end with it. An evangelist needs the prophetic, sir. Leo, you need a prophetic. In the field, prophetic evangelism is very easy. Sometimes when you step into certain locations, they will hear your Jesus. Tell them something, they will shut down. A pastor may be educating your senses. Certain time when he pick something, suddenly you will glitter. A teacher can be grounding you, you will be so bogus, you argue with everybody, arguing how this thing is not captured within doctrine. And you never done that many things that Jesus Christ did was not captured in books. And the prophet will give you that foresight and that hindsight. We need to stop this fighting we are doing in the body of Christ. You are too small
for God to walk alone with you. Any dimension you see, embrace it. If you have your way, sow into it. I have friends with all kinds of people. All kinds of people. If you are deceived, it's because you are wrong yourself. Any person that tell me that he is afraid of deception or error, it's because you are an erroneous person. If you are right, no matter how the error is, light will always shine in darkness. You won't be contaminated. I have been good with friends that are Babalawo. I have been good with friends that drink blood. That look like somebody that drink blood to you. No. I learn from witches and wizards sometimes. Sometimes before I cast out the devil, I say, how do you do in your kingdom? Teach me. Some of them know more spiritual intelligence than you. You need to learn from them. Your faith is too beggarly. It's hard for you to believe that God can lift you. You don't even believe that a common exam written by mortal men can be changed. And how can you transact things that are in the realm of the spirit to the physical? If you can't believe carnal things, you need to ask those guys that drink blood, how do you used to leave your body and go to meeting at night? That first question. After the 1 hour education, you will have more faith. How do you used to capture people and tie their soul in witchcraft? You will realize that those guys operate more faith than you. Ah, it is well. You are struggling to fly in the spirit. When you go to China, it's a normal thing they do. It's their morning devotion. Those yoga guys don't need for Jesus to do that. Hey, let me tell you, there are many things that we look upon that are mundane. When certain knowledge is educated upon your spirit, it functions by default. We have been empowered in our soul and in our body and in our mind. Our spirit has been beggarly, is deficient. There are things that when you know now, you will remain like this. I guarantee you, your sleep cannot be normal. I was in past cars as I closed my eyes. Wah! I was in the spirit. That's your place of advantage. Everything you see, all and did was in the realm of the spirit. I will teach you how God talks. I will teach you the pattern. And you live as though the causes doesn't exist. They may be there. Alexander though has causes. Abraham has causes. He proved all of them to you. You saw it, right? Everybody has a cause. Everybody. But let me tell you, God bailed them out of it. The problem is that you have not found your recovery system. If you have found it, you will live as though the devil don't exist. Because anytime something comes, God will always give you an option. If I'm not supposed to be here, I won't be here. There is a way God will communicate it in such a way that I won't be here. If there is a bomb that will explode here, I won't be here. You may be here in the flesh. I won't be here. If I'm here, if it explodes, I will still remain. Because if God did not tell me anything, if I'm here, nothing will happen. If you understand how God communicates, you won't travel and say you cover the car with the blood of Jesus. You say, devil, let's meet on the highway. Because God will always keep his own side of the bargain. And many more times when we want to go for outreach, we look for what can kill us. So that if we cannot find anyone, we are sure that the God we have is true. Because if all the God you have is the one you have been learning in Bible school, the day you go out, you discover that the practical is hard. Learn the practical so that when you come here, it's easier. You have not been hearing God for so long. Now, 10 guys ask you out and you want to hear God. How? It doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that. In hearing God, there has to be consistency. Sustain the strings for us. You know, Roland took us high. And it was high for me to keep up to the standard. But
We will see how we do.
Many of you, I think I saw you in the last meeting I came. Yeah, I remember. You see, we don't need too many people. If you've been to Lagos, you see thousands of people that go to church every Sunday. Many of them are possessed. Many of them are demonized. Many of them are the problem we have. We just need a man. I used to tell, since if we can have like 10 of Roland and Toby in this campus, we'll be safe. With only 1,000, because it's impossible. Not everybody will subscribe and remain consistent in the discipline for that long. When I go to play, I know in the next 10 years many people will backslide. Among even you here, I'm not lying, it's the truth. Because there are many people that will start and won't complete it. But the few that will remain, to be reckoned of them. The first thing you must understand is that causes are real. These patterns are very, very real. If you lie to yourself, you are already deceived. If you say you cannot be deceived, according to scripture, you are already deceived. I told you that causes, even according to Webster, it lets you understand that it is a supernatural detriment or hindrance, a ban, a prayer or a precaution that harm may befall someone. So somebody pray for a cause to come. Somebody must have to pray to avert a cause. Many things I function in God, I pray into them. It's safer. It's safer. The devil will not want to see you rise like that. He will awake every demon in your family to come after you. Many of us learn by our failing. We fail many more times than we learn the hard way. It's part of the courses. And patterns are like the modus operandi of how courses work. When they establish a course, they establish a pattern so that it can remain. It's a system of operation. So that it will not miss anybody in the lineage. That's patterns. It's a design. It's an experimental model that can always guarantee result to all the generation. The Bible says, I will visit the curses to a fourth generation. Go down four generation, down your lineage. You find out that they are idol worshippers. They serve them very well. And many of these are apparently good loyalty to idols. They serve and they even gave the unborn children to the devil. They swear all of us into it. And some of these causes have a timing for their manifestation. And that's to say there are some that can only gain the life when you enter school. Another one will only get the life when you marry. Another one when you give birth to a child. Another one when you get a job. These things are programmed. It's like a step-by-step calculation. It is upon this pattern that I believe that every believer that must survive in God must subscribe to the pathway of prayer at least for the minimum of 5 years. You must understand how to consistently live above these things. It's not as if they will not be there, as he said, but you always have a wisdom against them. I wrote Wayek, I wrote Neko, Interna, Estana, more than 10 times. Nobody does that. Nobody. Everybody in my family was the same thing. And I thought it was because I went to a school that was not paying more fee. My sister that went to a school paid 70,000 for school fees. Secondary school. She's still writing Wayek now. Everybody passed, only half failed. My other sister had to go. She gained admission. When she was in 300 level, she has to be withdrawn because she had deficiency in all levels. You don't know how these courses work. They are terrible. When I was about to be withdrawn in 2014, that was when I was supposed to graduate because I entered school 2009, 2010. That was when I was able to write it again and I passed. After I've written more than 10 times. I've wrote internal, external jam, what they call it, NAPTEP. Oh, there are plenty of them. I was just looking for an opportunity to pass. Anytime I see the result, it breaks my heart, and I was still a preacher. Well, I started hearing God 2009. But that thing did not respect hearing God. It was there. I mean, we're talking about Moses, how that Moses came up from the presence of God 40 days and 40 nights. His face grew. Would there be any kind of glory needed than that one? But immediately when he appeared before the children of Israel, he broke the Ten Commandments in one day. Anger. After coming up from the presence of God 40 days and 40 nights, patterns are terrible. Abraham went. He went to Pharaoh, right? He lied that Sarah is his sister. Nobody told Isaac. Isaac went again and said, is it Rebecca? He said, his sister. I mean, these things are real. And I guarantee you they are real. When you see certain things are consistently there in your family, don't just look at them just like that. Somebody came and met me in Zaria, her brother. For 13 years old, he's diagnosed of two kidney failure. What does it when nearly has his kidney start working? And I said, who else has that in your family? She said, our mother just died of two kidney failure. I said, what are you doing? You better start praying. If not, this thing will keep traveling. It will keep traveling. Every child was born with a curse. You may be born innocent, eh? There's a curse. Adam subscribers to it. Christ redeemed you from the curse of the law. There are certain curses that are not curses of the law. It is the one we inherited. Our parents created that covenant themselves. It was not part of what Christ redeemed you from. Part of the curse of the law is spiritual death, sicknesses, and maybe poverty. But let me tell you, you can be a rich man with anger, a rich man with stealing, a rich man with all kinds of. So there are other things that are causes that are not part of the curse of the law. How all of a sudden everybody in the family is struggling to just get as simple as getting a guy is hard. When they look at you, they look at you as an old woman. No matter the medicine you apply, nobody care. They love to have you as a friend, nobody will talk about marriage. They like to have you as a sex mate. Nobody talk about serious relationship. How comes you carry yourself from church to a boyfriend house and begging? And then lady that begged people to sleep with her. She begged. Slept with more than 200 guys. That cannot be normal. I have met prostitutes that told me that they don't even like what they are doing. And you, when you like it, it's a curse. Ask your mother very well. See, many things are patterns. We are very innocent of many things, I tell you the truth. But your innocency won't save you from anything. Your problem may just be that you are not spiritual. The Rachel was weeping that her children were no more. The children were children at the wrong time. If they start pursuing people now to kill, you have a younger brother. He cannot run. The problem is he's just your younger brother at the wrong time. Think I'm saying? Curses and patterns are real. I mean, they are very, very real. Very, very real. It took me so much, so long to break them. My dad is very poor in management of money. When I realized that I vowed I will never hold my ATM, I will give it to my wife. That's the wisdom to save myself from it. A man has anger. And I realized that just as to be say, just as Roland say, I learned to be playful. Sometimes I joke, I play. It's a way to help me out of it. If you take every word that people say very serious, you don't want to go far with God. Everybody will offend you. Even yourself, you will offend yourself. See, these works of the flesh, all of them are curses. Anger, lust, fornication, pride are curses. Works of the flesh. To each and every one of them, you must apportion a kind of the fruit of the Spirit to cover for them. Learn to have self-control. Before God began to commit ladies towards my direction, one thing he asked was a very strange question. He said, can I trust you with the daughters of Zion? That if one that has a cause come and naked herself, what will you do? You are running away from it. But like Joseph, sometimes it comes right to your door. When I was at Victoria Island, I saw naked prostitutes with good cars. They can pay you. There are people that will pay you for the cause. How come Samson was so anointed, but he find compatibility with the lives of the light? Don't you ask yourself that? When you check his leaders very well, you find out that it was coming from somewhere. Causes are real. Don't say that they are very, very, I mean they are very, 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 very real. Bible talk about how that in heaven they were deliberating how to kill King Jehoshaphat. And a spirit volunteer from heaven to come and possess all the other 400 or something prophets, right? And all of them prophesied lie from a curse. Only one person, Micaiah, spoke without a curse. And even the one that was speaking from a curse slapped him and said, when did God? These patterns are real. You can be 400 prophets speaking the same lie. It's possible. Now we talk about how that when the Spirit of God left Saul, a spirit from heaven came to torment him daily. It was a curse. These things are real. I mean, they are very, very real. They cannot keep phone in your room and forget it, and you will look for the owner. You will speak in tongues as he carried it with tongues. Ask your father or ask your mother. Something is wrong somewhere. Everybody in your family was once upon a time on fire for God. Now they are backslidden. And you are feeling like not to pray. You are feeling like discrediting God. You better wake up. You will join them very soon. It's just a matter of when. Any believer that is not consistent with fasting, prayer and study, he will backslide. It's just a matter of when. I'm very serious. Even if he's preaching and healing the sick, the same pattern that brought him to this level, he must continue it. In this thing is continuity. What you did today, what you are doing today is what you did yesterday. Do you know that? It's what you did yesterday that brought you to this point today. What you are doing now is what will take you to where you go tomorrow. If you neglect what you are doing now, if you are not putting the same energy, tomorrow you won't have no tomorrow. You will not have it. That's sometimes when I gaze at people's passion and zeal, I know that guy. If God tarry, after 4 years, 3 years, this person won't be here. You will have so much problems. We trust God that at the end of this little convergence, you don't just be educated in your mind, but your spirit be impacted so that you can grow in the impactation. The greatest thing that can happen to a believer is to receive impactation. Forget about how that it has been compromised, a lie. We are product of impactation, I won't lie. There's nothing that I'm looking for in God that somebody doesn't have yet. Have you prayed more than them, Babalola? I don't think so. Have you fasted more than most of you? You have not done that. I have done, no. But there are many things that you are doing now. There are people that have run more than you. Do you get what I'm saying now? So if you can get impartation from them, you can go further. But the problem is that people are not consistent with impartation. They don't even know how to survive it. They don't even know how to grow in impartations. So they can tell you, I've met this person. But do you know their life? They are still struggling to pray, struggling to fast, struggling to... You have not received the impartation. and you don't have the capacity to contain it. God can come here now, give you one dose, two dose, three dose. Some of us will borrow vessels. Can you go in the impartation of what you are receiving? We need it. It's very important. Leo, you have to be consistent. I want after the next 10 years, I will see here many more things. But that's a goal. After 10 years, let me hear Roland. I don't know what I'm saying. He cannot be your friend. Don't, you know, this. There are people that say, you are far now. Apostle, I say, you see, you want me to remain small. I can't be your friend. I'm very serious. You better run faster as I'm running. Else I will need binoculars to find you. Oyedepo say 20 children can't play together for 20 years. It's an error if you are playing together for 20 years. Destiny will always separate you. You are not mate with anybody. The Bible says them that compare themselves to themselves are not wise. Your standard is Christ. But you make sure you are going higher. And if you don't grow, you will be angry with many people that are going further. Look at what he's doing. He's bright. He's arrogant. He's bright. There are many people that lay hands on us today, sir. They are not on faith. They are not in faith. So there were people we are looking up to. Today, they have left Jesus. They were once upon a time anointed. See, the experiences of the past does not validate the now. What is God saying now? Some people used to be where God used to be. They don't know where God is now. The voice of God has to be a perpetual continuum. The difference between life and death has to be the voice of God. What God is telling you now. I remember when I was about to come to Abuja one time and I just put my neck to enter a vehicle. The Lord said, Philip, if you enter this car, they will cut your neck. It's not time for me to speak in tongues. I removed my leg. The man said, enter, enter. I said, no. There is a voice that I used to hear. If I disobey it, I cry. If you know the voice of God, if you disobey, you cry. You can't disobey God and sleep. Even if you are a sinner. Except he has not talked to you before. Because that's where your security lies. When Cain killed Abel, he heard God. And he has to answer. Nobody hear the voice of God and disobey. It's a lie. Do you know the end of it? Dead. Ask Balaam. Is it Balaam or Balak? I must curse Israel. Say, bless them. I must curse. He devised a means. Position the constellation. Because these guys have potent power. Anybody can engage them. And if you can engage them very well and offer the right sacrifice, they will influence the earth. And they will cause havoc. They can open this ground and they will swallow all of us. A star can fall upon all of us now and are gone. Somebody can get angry and release a star from heaven and they fall upon 5-story building and everybody will die there. Because nobody is praying there. Powers are real. Causes are real. These things are very, very real. The Bible says, plotting out every handwriting and every ordinances. You don't just change an ordinance. You do another ordinance against it. It's like the law of the Medes and the Persians. When you write it, even you that write it, you can't change it. You have to write another law greater than that one. Like, okay, the soul that sin must die, right? Okay, the soul that sin, my blood can. That's how it works. There are certain ordinances that have already been spoken. If you don't write another one, it will work whether you like it or not. It's just a matter of time. Some of us change those things by prayer. I gave my life to prayer for many years. Wasted time for prayer. And my consolation was that I never see somebody that died praying. And since I realized that I have never seen anybody that died praying, I decided that I will kill myself praying. And I realized that the more I pray, the more I live. I was dying, but I was living. And let me tell you the truth. Visions broke out. Revelation broke out. Angelic encounter broke out. Prayer is like a mother of a thousand blessings. It will lead you to all blessings. I'm very serious. A man that pray can never be limited. He can be in prison today, he'll be out tomorrow. Put him in fire, he'll be burning, but he will survive. Many dimensions you convert in God, most times you have received their impactations. God is not that wicked, he can give very fast. But let me tell you, growing in those impactations will require a lot of prayer, obedience, and high level investment in energy. The greatest challenge of a believer is translating prophecy to manifestation. That time of life, the time appointed for the fulfillment of prophecy, is a problem. And even if the prophet said by this time tomorrow, he bank upon the recipe of his obedience in God, sometimes God can look at you and say no. Because sometimes we just want to help a Jonah. Now God wants him to go to Nineveh. Hold on, say something very powerful, that until your obedience is complete, you can't gaze at some of these things. When you enter a certain location, don't go and bind any prince. If you know you just came out from masturbation, pornography, or maybe you just finished sleeping with a guy, don't bind anything. Keep quiet. If you thought you received a slap, not very serious. Every intercessor must understand the way of purity. It's very, very important. Learn to repent daily. I do that daily. It's an escape route. Repentance is for believers, it's not for unbelievers. Even the Bible says, even God repented. Learn to repent. You don't born again, repent. He can always save you. The Holy Spirit has dealt so much on the causes. So let me see if I can talk a little about the voice of God. He combined both the causes, patterns, and the voice of God. But let me just see if I can just give you a little perspective to how you can keep up with the patterns and the speakings of God. It's very important. If you are deprived of hearing God, it's a problem. Every believer must learn God. There are days where your pastor will not be there. Do you know that? I'm very serious. There are days where Rulam may not be there. There are days where Toby may not be there. There are days where the people you look up to, Leo, will not be there. Omeka, all the rest. What will you do? Take at it now. So you must learn it yourself. It's very important. How do you become born again? God talked to you. Do you know that? You heard a voice. I'm very serious. Why are you not in the club now? A voice told you that one is wrong. Alright? I want to bring you from conscience. Then we'll come to grace. Nobody does an evil thing and doesn't know. You will know. Do you know you have a spirit before the spirit of God comes upon you? Do you know that? And your conscience is part of your spirit. It's an inner witness. The ability to discern between good and evil is there. Before you can will, sin comes when you will. Are you getting it now? That's the Bible said, to him who knows what to do and refuses to do it, to him is a sin. It's a will. Because God will always permit ignorance. Somebody met me and say, it's not written in scripture not to smoke, no, they are saying. He said, I cannot hold him responsible for that. I said, okay. The Bible said, whatever you do and your conscience do not judge you, it's not a sin. That's true. Have your conscience ever judges you to smoke? It's not that you refuse it, because you can deaden your conscience and slit somebody's throat and still be okay. But Boko Haram believe that it's righteousness. That's the truth. That's what they believe. So it's possible that what you are hearing may be wrong, or what you are believing may be wrong. And if your believing is wrong, your living will definitely also be wrong. Do you know if you choose to go and rob a bank, if you say you want to go and rob a bank tomorrow morning, the Holy Spirit will not stop you, but he will prompt you. This is not right. It's not right. But your ability to be able to respond to that prompting of the Spirit is very important. One of the basic ways that God speaks that I've known, I told you, the prophetic works so much with the cognitive ways that God speaks. The apostolic work much more with the non-cognitive ways. Thus, the prophetic work more with the intellectual ways. The apostolic work much more on the non-intellectual ways. I'm not hearing this, your strings. You know, some keyboard have two kind of strings. You know which one you are. You know, preaching is not talking. No, you need to learn how to link yourself to unction and utterance. Obviously, you have an unction from the Holy One, you know all things. And utterance has to be given unto you to speak. Without unction, without utterance, you can't talk. Rather, you can just talk and it's just the mind of people that will be educated, not their spirit. If you want to educate the spirit of people, you need unction and you need utterance. Because sometimes you can have so much in your heart to say and you can't say anything. No utterance. The Bible says, I know my sheep and my sheep knows me. They hear my voice and I hear their voice. The first deception the devil will tell you is that you can't hear the voice of God. If you believe that one, I can't help you. You have to disbelieve that one before we can help you. The Bible says, except a man be born again, he cannot enter into the kingdom of heaven. Is that not true? When you go downward, the Bible said, except a man be born of what? Of water and of spirit, he cannot see to the kingdom. The day you begin to see, you know, you can see the voice of God, you can hear the voice of God, you can know the voice of God, you can perceive the voice of God. The voice of God can be anything. God can talk to anything. You just have to be open. The Bible speaking in the book of Job, he said, God speak, yea, men do not perceive him. Say, in the vision of the night, when deep sleep fall upon men, he opened their heart and he pushed instruction inside of them. Many more times you are too distracted to hear the voice of God. A man that has not learned to dwell with God will never be familiar with the voice of God. You must learn dwelling with God. You must dwell. Many more years, because I was plagued with pornography, I was sleeping around pornography, all those things, and it was terrible. I was having vision natural, both in the afternoon, in the evening, in the night, in the daytime. I was on visions. You can't be watching all those things and have vision. What do you mean? Clear ones. So when I got born again, I had to replace those thought patterns. Are you getting it? So I had to sit with the Bible, lock myself inside for weeks sometimes. Cover to cover, Genesis to Revelation, go back again. So I was just possessing myself with scriptures. Suddenly, sometimes I'm reading the scripture, my eyes will close and my eyes will open. You get it? So the more I was dwelling with the scriptures, visions were opening. I can be reading the scripture, Lord, not give me word for somebody that is not in my room. So as I was dwelling with the scripture, it was enough to grant me vision. When I opened my mouth to begin to pray, my eyes began to be open again. And I realize that when you possess and eat so much of God in you, it begins to find expression. It tries to come out one way or the other. You cannot be possessed with God and people will not know he's alive. One day you betray yourself. You'll be walking in the street before you head. I'm among people. You'll be in the class, you don't know when you start. I don't know how. It is an influence. For you to hear God, you need to be influenced by the Spirit of God, because it's the Spirit of God that talks to you. The Holy Ghost is a talking and a speaking spirit. God is always doing something. Forget those people that tell you that God is not always talking. God is always talking. He may not be only talking to you, but he's talking about somebody else. And if God is doing something, do you know that somebody has to be willing to be conscious enough to see what he's doing? Do you know that? God is always saying something. Even if you are the one that created only Babalada, you will be busy 24 hours in a day. The last time God rested was, according to Genesis, we have never heard that again. The one we had is that he doesn't sleep or slumber. After creation was put in place, mankind was born. God cannot rest. You and me and you can't allow him to rest. When he rested was when we were not yet created. Now he's very busy. He's always saying something, he's always doing something. Somebody has to be willing to position himself aright to see what he's doing. Somebody has to position himself to hear what he's saying. Say, watchman, oh watchman, what about last night? If you have stood in my counsel, you could have heard my word. You have to stand. See, you have to. You can only hear God when your heart posture is right. If your heart posture is wrong, you can never hear God. You need to give him time. I mean time, so much time. That Shiran that this was saying, I didn't just go my own, I had the Holy Ghost. If I go my own, I won't be here. If you have been to Kogi State before, the Kina Kingdom, I have told those places for outreach. Itetokbe, Iyale, all those places. Every house have an idol. Even they are Muslims, they have a shrine. They don't care to go to church and go to mosque, they will still go to their shrine. And when you come and say, let's break it, they will say no. It's a pattern. When I got angry, I said, okay, I won't break the one in your house, I want to go to the Ogapata. When they call the man, the man refused to come out, I get angry, I defile the shrine. I remove my trousers, I defecate inside. So that he can never use it again. The gods will run away. They don't like that. A man came at night. I don't know where a dagger appeared in my hand and I struck him very well. Many people began to die in the land. So let me tell you. If you hear God, anything you do, if God directs you, walk. I'm very serious. God will always reveal something to deal with it. If he tell you carry this thing to your room, tomorrow it will turn to gold. Don't ask how, just carry it. I'm very serious. Men that walk with God, don't ask God questions of how. God will never answer you how. Abraham, take your son. Don't ask how. Get out of your father's house. Don't just ask and just go. Obedience first. It's like a military system. You obey before you complain. Many of you have deprived yourself of testimony because you have not obeyed. You ask yourself, what if it doesn't work? What if it doesn't? What if it works? Disobedience is very simple. You just need to learn how to just yield to the Spirit of God. Be simple to it and be open. I said that the prophetic work basically mostly with the intellectual speakings of God. And part of the intellectual speakings of God are dreams. And what I mean by intellectual speakings of God, I mean a speaking that you can relate with your mind. many more times. God can flow through your mind. Somebody asked me, how do I see vision? I say, I use my mind, my mind. No, it's not the time I see it on screen. No, sometimes it's just a thought that comes from your mind. I'm very serious. You are just distracted, that's why you don't know the real thought. I'm very serious. And you know your heart has a mind, has the mind of the heart. It talks, it sees too. Because that's where your spirit is. Dream is one of the effective ways that God can talk to you. Embrace it. Many of you took dreams so casual. See, it's not just a dream. That was what Joseph had. Dream. He made him a great man. Do you know that? That was what Daniel had. Those guys, it's just dream. Dream and interpretation. Dream and interpretation. So much in your dreams, you are writing them down and praying for their interpretations. It will not take long. God will leave that pattern for you as a way of speaking. And anytime a situation approach you, you say, give me one night, you go and sleep. The revelation will come and the interpretation will come. When you take it as a casual thing, it's just a dream, it will not take long. God will forget it. Even dream, it will be hard for you to have dream. Many of you should have dream before you're not having again. Why? Because you took them casual. I see God doesn't reveal anything for fun. Anything God revealed to you is very, very serious about it. And as long as you don't take them serious, it will not be long. He will let it go. He will shut down the portal. He shut down the valve. People that hear God take the voice of God serious. They don't joke with it. Even if it was a simple thing, they will write it down. My phone is full of notepad of writings. I don't joke with anything I hear. Even if I just perceive it, I write it. You say, you wake up, it's just a dream now. Because sometimes you cannot see a vision. You cannot hear a word. But since you are too busy, when you are sleeping, God will open your heart and put a dream. And give an instruction in the dream. You have been taking it casual as you are waking up, because the devil come but to steal and kill and destroy. As you are waking up, you forget it because you don't care to write them down. 0.3 or 0.4 seconds as you are waking up, you still remember the dream. But as you wake up, you are not careful to document it. That's how it will go in later in the afternoon. Say, the dream, I can't remember. That was an instruction that was supposed to save you a lifetime. The devil has stolen it. To certain places sometimes and you feel as though you are there before. Have you been talking to people sometimes? I think we have talked this thing before. Many more times it's part of the dream that devil stole. So God help you when the reality occurs, it down on you again. God has been talking to you, have been neglecting him. Don't say he doesn't talk. You have been neglecting. Have you sometimes see yourself in your village in the dream? Sometimes you say praying in specific locations in dreams. Have you sometimes received specific instructions in dreams and you refuse to obey them? It's just a dream. That's why it's just your life. I have books that I've been writing dreams 9. So date. I saw this. I wrote them down. So date. It may look stupid, Keep them. Some dreams can come from your soul, emotions, your spirit. See, just keep all of them. You will need them. They will give you wisdom, as Roland said. Sometimes God warned me beforehand before a thing in a dream. How did Daniel receive the revelation for Mene Mene Tekel Upas? He said, give us a night. Let's go. Let me just go and sleep. I know if I close my eye, I will be in the spirit. As he closed his eyes, suddenly he saw. The voice of God is found in the realm of the spirit. It's not in your realm here. Many of you want to hear God in the flesh. No, you can't. It's impossible. Is it that you initiate a sacrifice that answer to the realm of the spirit, then permit an answer to come? Or you learn how to perpetually, habitually dwell in that realm? Ezekiel said, I was in the spirit. Then he began to see heaven open. I don't know where he was before, but he was part of people that were taken to captivity by the river Kappa, and suddenly his eyes was open and he was in the spirit. When he was in the spirit, he began to hear God and began to see visions. The voice of the Lord is in the spirit, it's not here. You have been in the flesh for so long, the flesh profit nothing but death. The spirit is what gives life. The Bible says, the spirit has spoken to you, their spirit and their life. You write upon them to reach the cleft of the realm of the spirit. When Ezekiel was given the advantage to be in the spirit that day, he began to translocate himself to diverse places. He will say, the spirit take me, and took me to the Asian foundation of Israel, and begin to show him the atrocity. The spirit of God begin to take him to diverse places, past, present, future of Israel, and show them what wisdom they need to do and how long they are supposed to remain in that captivity. If there was not a man that can be in the spirit, there would not be an answer to any of. He will be part of the captivity today as a prophet, ordained to be a prophet from his mother's womb. So much reality about your life in the realm of the spirit. You have been so carnal for so long. John the Beloved was banished to the island of Patmos to die. Suddenly he was in the spirit. When he was there, he began to hear the voice of God and he began to hide. You have been in the flesh for so long and you have been talking in tongue in the flesh. A woman slept with the senator and she wake up and she began to say, pakata, 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 pakata. Senator said, what are you doing? She said, I want to check whether the Holy Ghost is still with me. The Holy Ghost has left you since. You are just in the flesh. All what you have is tongues. See, if all what you know about prayer is just tongues, you will get weary. That's the easiest way I know you will get weary. You start with tongues, you don't end in tongues. Tongues is just a part of prayer. People say Philip is a man of prayer. You think I'm only strong all the time, it's a lie. I'm very weak. But you know how I pray. Have you ever tried to see the end of your tongues before? We try it sometimes, many more times. In Lafayette, sometimes the last one we told you was 50 hours of prayer. When you have prayed for 50 hours, you'll be tired. I mean, it's not a prophecy. You will be tired. To open your mouth, it will be hard. And you are praying and fasting. You will understand other ways of prayer. Because there are kinds of prayers. You must understand supplication, petitions, thanksgiving, intercessions. You must learn how to start. Some days I can just be inside and just be thanking Jesus for 1 hour. And it's as good as if I'm speaking in tongues. Some days I can just be shouting. Some days I can just be chanting. Other days I will just be dancing. When the Bible says pray without ceasing, you think it's tongues. Keep saying that in your working place, it will push you out. You must understand other patterns of prayer. Do you know your spirit can be praying inside of you? Sleeping, tongues is boiling inside of you. You can remain perpetually in the spirit. The Bible said, walk in the spirit and you will not gratify the desire of the flesh. So for the flesh is in contention with the spirit. Both of them are fighting. The spirit realm is your place of advantage. That's where the voice of God exists. John the Beloved said, I was in the spirit on the last day. And I hear. He was banished to die. I don't know where he was before. They tie him and put him inside water. He refused to die. They put him inside oil and fry him. He refused to die. So they tie his hand and use a horse and drag him to the island of Patmos. When they were dragging him, do you know they did not carry him? They actually tied him and they were throwing him. His body did not pain. Because was a proclamation that one of them will not see dead. He won't be martyred until he see the Christ. See, you don't fight prophecy when it's spoken. No. You can either pray for it or against it. So if you say you will receive a car, as Roland is just saying like this, spirit that he prayed that works with him, we ensure that a car find a way. So that you refuse it or you pray against it. Or you pray for it. And suddenly when he was banished to the island of Patmos to die, no food, no water. Do you know why God initiated hunger? Natural hunger. Is it to punish you? Have you felt hungry before? Hunger. Who was sharing that you were saying that after you finish praying and for you drink gari, you should believe you. See, let me tell you, you don't will test the extent of your love for Jesus. How much more you've pray and fasted and break it with gari. For many years we have done that. There are times on campus where we drink gari for 1 week. I have a friend that soaked gari, he will soak it. Yeah? So that it will keep increasing. For 1 week he's soaking. So he's fetching from the boil of the one he soaked. You don't understand. And you will still be praying. When God saw that, he cannot but anoint you. See, there are dangerous things that you do that God cannot, he can't say no. The realm of the spirit answer nothing but to sacrifice. There are things that you do, God will come by force. Nobody told Solomon to bond 1,000 cattle, right? Go and buy 1,000 cattle, set them on fire. A spirit will come and ask you, why are you doing that? Why? Now, very serious. I don't have time to teach you about priesthood. Priesthood require dangerous things. Priesthood is greater than sacrifice. It's a kind of sacrifice. However, sometimes God can say, your eating should start by 2 o'clock every day. Every day for 1 week. 1 week. You'll be eating from 2 o'clock at night. He said, you're not sleeping in your house again. Every day, come out. Just stay outside of your house. Daybreak. What do you think God was doing with people like Ezekiel when you were saying them to lie down like this? For what? Please don't stop that. What do you think he was doing? Certain kind of sacrifice will be demanded from you. And God will do that to test your compliance, how much more you can obey him. See, no voice of the devil will tell you sow a seed. I'm very serious. No devil will tell you sow a seed. He will tell you buy Medicare or buy something. Buy chocolate. How you talk there? Sometimes we'll use our pocket money and buy books, buy everything. Survive. At least gari is cheap. See, gari has been saving the life of students for. Gari deserves Nobel Prize. Oh, it is half an hour. There has to be a Gari day. Day of Gari celebration. What? From primary, secondary and tertiary institution. My God. There has to be subsidy for that. That's saving spiritual brothers. See, smoke it. And still keep praying. I don't know where he was, but the Bible says he was on the spirit on the Lord's day, and he hear. Prayer will take you through the journey into the realm of the spirit. Prayer to take you by force. I was praying one day, bada, 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 bada. I hear a wind came and blew me, took me there. I was happy, at least a wind can blow me. My prayer can bring a wind. I broke my hand, but I was glad. I ran to Jesus and said, Apostle, you see, God used to talk. He has blown me now. Say, Philip, next time, just remain. Even when you fall down, don't stand up and clean your body, just remain. Some of you run faster. Sometimes you will dwell and you won't hear anything. Just remain. I'm telling you, sometimes you may not hear a voice, you may not hear anything. Just remain. Some of you separate time that you want to dwell with God. As you start, you check your WhatsApp chat. You enter Facebook. You are not serious. Nobody talks to spirit like that. God is a spirit, mind you. He's in the realm of the spirit. He transacts with spirit by strong dedication and commitment. I'm telling you the truth. And don't tell me you can be in the two realm. No, you are either in one. Paul says that I'm present with you, I'm absent with you. Whatever way, I'm still in Christ. But the problem is the place of advantage is that one. The Bible says they go from strength to strength, all of them that appear before God in Zion, not them that come, appear. It will take an appearance. The Bible says God has blessed us with all spiritual blessings, but in heavenly places in Christ. It's in a place, not just, no. No blessing come from anywhere, it come from above. I'm very serious. People are stingy, they can't give you anything. But when God forces it, they can't help but do it. I'm very serious. It can happen in such a way that you see a prophet flogging you. Pay the tithe. Now, very serious. Some of us, God have to appear to us and do strange to make us obey certain things. People that disobey God and enjoy are trying, you know. It's hard to disobey God. And it's costly. Let me hush it so that we can just pray. Another one is vision. Part of the intellectual way that God talks is vision. And I say these are prominent, most time prophetic people, visions. And many more times a vision is an interruption in your sight. It comes as a scenery of event. Suddenly you are normally thinking and suddenly you are thinking switch. As we are here, suddenly you start, Roland was just, he said, I don't even know how he started thinking of one lady from where, I don't know. That's a vision comes. It's strange. As you are looking at people here, you suddenly, sometimes you just feel as though something switched from the inside of your eye. Suddenly you are seeing double. As if you are drunk somehow. And sometimes it comes as though it's a scenery of event. Sometimes it comes as if it's a flashing of light, just like you just like a shoe pass. And you can remember the color of the shoe, but you don't know. But you just it's an inspired communication by the Holy Spirit. Because in the realm of the spirit, there are things that exist and substance that exist. Sometimes you can literally see names written. You can see it as if an alphabet are dancing. I'm very serious. I know a lady that can just look at this thing like this and she'll see writings in them. Seriously. Trivialize any spiritual experience that is happening with you. You may not understand it, right? But it's a communication that God is doing. Because many more times God wants to talk to you, but in a unique way that only you can understand. So he wants you to master that way. But he's saying, I don't understand this thing. Try to understand it. We call it the unspoken words of the Holy Spirit. Suddenly you are praying and your hand is shaking. And you stop praying and you stop shaking. When you are praying, you start shaking again. Find out what is it. It's a talking. It's a communication. Sometimes you are praying and your eye is burning with fire. When you stop, you stop. But when you are praying, it burns. Ask the Holy Spirit. He will tell you. you can be praying and you begin to feel that your neck is getting cold. All these things are talking. They are unspoken communication of the Holy Spirit. They may not mean anything to anybody, but they mean something to you. I'm telling you the truth. There is no communication that the Holy Ghost is doing with you that is not paramount. Another way, another one of the intellectual speakings is trance. Cherubim and Seraphim Church are found of that many more times. They can be a prime meeting, so many people will enter trance for days. They are unconscious. When you come, they are talking from kilometers away when you are coming. It's the head downloading your life. It was Peter that gave us an understanding that he was in your house at Joppa, right? And suddenly he had a chance and he saw a sheet that was laid down from heaven and with all kinds of animals, and he was told to kill and eat. That was God talking to him. God did not say, Peter, no. That came from a chance, then a voice. But one of the ways that God does is that he combines all of these modes all together to talk to you. Sometimes a vision can come to confirm a dream. Sometimes a dream can come to confirm a vision. Sometimes a trance can come to confirm the other one. That's how God does it. Have you been lost in thought sometimes? You're talking to someone and suddenly you're gone. It's as if you have left the person and later you come back again. And like, what were you saying again? The person like, you're not focusing, you're not hearing me say. No, you have been caught up into another realm. And within those split minutes and seconds, many more times, if you are careful enough. See, poverty people know how to reduce their seconds to millions of seconds to minutes of seconds. Because God talks fast. He talks as light. The voice of God comes as light. You decode it to the level of knowledge you understand. And many more times it comes as revelations. Revelation is personal, private to the core of your being. When it comes, it's alive. You just know that there is a pain in your hand and nobody has a pain here. Nobody will believe you, but you know. You just know that this one, it's not guessing, it's a revelation. But because sometimes, as Jesus said, you call it and call it and call it. It may not be even word of knowledge. Word of knowledge may be so accurate that you can even go and point the person and say, come here. Revelation, you just know that you know that you know. But you know, just like the way you just know your name is you. There are many people that will bear you the kind of name, but you just know that your own is your own. See, nobody has to point you to your father. You know your father is your father. Everybody knows his father. That's revelation. If there are sisters here or brothers here, nobody may know, but you know yourself. If there is somebody here that knows you love somebody here, nobody may know, but you just know. You don't know how that revelation works. There is a knowing that no matter how, it just dwells there. Because it's personal and it's intimate to the core of your being. You wake up sometimes and you just know that if I go out today, my phone will be lost. That is that knowing. You just wake up and you just know it. I'm telling you, you went out and suddenly you, as you check your phone later, you didn't see it. God was talking to you through a revelation. And part of that consists inner knowing and inner witness. You just know. It's part of the gift that God gives in the conscience to decipher good and evil. A guy came and asked you that, and you just know that this person is not consistent. You just know that this guy has other ladies. He may be very innocent. In fact, you find him in church when he was little young and he was crying. But there was no, this guy is a bad guy. You can't explain it, but you just know. It's when you began with him that after 1 year you realize that he's a bad boy. But it's too late. See, don't neglect those knowing inside. Actually, sometimes the Lord lets you to. Sorry, my dear. to read a topic, you just know that this one will come out in the exam, and you are just weak to read it. But you know that this one will come out. Papa, you even tell people that this one will come out, listen. But you refuse to read it. You see that courses and pattern you are saying, right? And you went and you saw it, bam! Hey! And I tell them, see, God talks. You just need to pay more attention. Many people talk to God, they don't allow God to talk to them. God is talking at you. When you pray, watch. I pray and watch. When you see me pray, pray. I'm praying and I'm trying to hear. That's what you can write. When God will come, it's not tongue sometimes. Sometimes you come and challenge your convictions. Like you said, the voice of God. You need to be able to hear something or fall back to something. I'm very serious. If you cannot fall back to something, tongues will cease. Seriously. I wanted to just so that you can fine tune your spirit and fine tune your mind. There's no magic to this thing. I'm very serious. There's no magic to it. Many of you, God has been talking to you. You've just not been hearing. That was why Paul made a serious prayer in the book of Ephesians. About the day I was with Lawrence Oyo, one thing that he told me, that I said, Philip, I would love to pray so that believers, see if it is him, he will train people for 5 years to pray that Ephesians 4, is it 20? I say that the eye of your understanding be open so that you can be able to comprehend and understand. And when you sit down, begin to realize that, see, you run faster to the degree to which you can see. If you see clearer, you run faster. If you don't see, you run, you will fall. Speed comes with clarity. Many people can't take the next step because they can't see. They are not sure. I'm very serious. Many people are confused because they cannot hear. They can't see. The Bible says, without vision, the people will perish. And it's true, you will perish. So you cannot know whether if you travel, something will happen. Or this. See, if God did not reveal it to you, no problem. But if he revealed it to you and you disobey, your leg may be cut and you will still enter heaven. But you fulfill heaven with one leg cut. Many people that disobey God, even if they are anointed, every disobedience will cost you something. Every disobedience. I'm very serious. It will cost you something. I'm very careful. Except if I don't really hear God. Sometimes, even if God says I should do something, even if it's hard, I will do it. I will cry, I will still do it. You think Abraham didn't cry? He cried. Jesus Christ cried, right? Yes. Hello, Master Batanai. Go, see this cup. But it's what they have agreed. It's hard. But it's better. Obedience is always better than sacrifice. I want you to take notice of all this I'm saying. Some of you have been having trance before, vision before, revelation before. You have neglected them. That's why God is not talking to you. I get it now. By the time you take them very serious, you can come to a meeting and you just hold somebody and suddenly you see something, you perceive something. And because you have been obeying God consistently, you understand the way he's talking. I'm telling you the truth. If you have been consistent in obedience, it will be easier. Anytime you obey God, disobedient die. Anytime you disobey God, you obedient die. There's another intellectual speaking of God that is daydreaming. Some people call it fantasy. Let me tell you. Have you just sat down sometime and just think, hey, suddenly you don't know how your thought took you and you just see yourself in a car. One of those cars that you like. Have you been upset in thought thinking? You just sit down one day. It's not as if you are thinking, no. But you are just in a future to come. That one no be vision. That one no be dream. That one no be revelation. That's daydreaming. It's part of a vision, but look like it can't be a vision. It's daydreaming. It's as if you are dreaming in the daytime. Somebody will call it vision of the day. Like vision of the night, like vision of the day. Many great people, they dream about their tomorrow. You may be here. You see yourself preaching to thousands. May not be a vision. Maybe a daydream. One day it will come to pass. You see yourself raising cripples. You see yourself raising the dead. You see all those possibilities. And you are engrossed. You are fantasizing about them. One day it will come to pass. It's part of the way God talks to you. It's the mind of Christ. Because the mind of Christ thinks possibilities. But say God can do far beyond that which you think or imagine. I get what I'm saying now. Part of your imagination provides to you daydreaming. You see yourself marrying a great person. You see yourself being great. No, it's not a bad thought. It's a good thought. It's a positive thought. You may be just be and just be seeing yourself that you're going to die tomorrow. See, don't take it for granted. Pray against it. It's just all thinking. Somebody say, oh, I just thought this thing. No, no. It was part of the way God communicated to you. I think we were just traveling before and suddenly you're just thinking as though there will be an accident in just a while. And you just read and it happened. And sometimes you were in a car and suddenly it's not like a vision, but you're just dreaming about an accident. And you just see yourself escape the situation. God talks in diverse manner. I'm telling you the truth. Sometimes I may be traveling for a meeting and I'll be daydreaming about the meeting before I reach there. I'll already be in the meeting before there. I'm already in the meeting. Oh, damn far. Part of the last cognitive way that God talks is spirit transport. People argue it. People talk against it. People say everything. I believe it so much. Why? Because it has happened to me several times. Just that if you continue like that for long, you may die in time. It takes so much energy. I have to stop it intentionally, consciously. I really stop it myself. And you can travel both with your spirit, or you can travel in your soul, or you can travel with your body. All I've tried work. The problem with all these things is this. It happens. It's supposed to happen by the prompting of the Holy Spirit. Problem I have with the realm of power is this. Some people engage it at will. It's hard to control the realm of power. If you know you can turn human being to chicken, the day you feel like eating chicken, won't you turn some of us to chicken? Bear the prophet. Bear, come. Eat these children. Eat. That was what Elijah did. Elisha, right? People just call him bareheaded. But just like maybe some children will see Ola and say, Ola, I don't know what he did completely better. He doesn't look well. Ola is fine. You know what I'm saying now? Suddenly he will get angry. Say, lion, eat this food. And because it's a realm of power, lion must come one way or the other. But any gift that God gives, he doesn't take it. Thank you. The day you begin to disappear, as we are in this meeting, you prove to us something. You disappear to your room and come back later. That's the problem. If you read in the scripture, the Bible says the Spirit took them. The Spirit took them. Our own, we take ourselves. I studied it so long that I understand how it works. It's aided by Spirit. Cherub, seraphs, ophanims, and certain light angels. They have wheels. They can travel with you. It became worse that they were so around, and I took pictures of them. See, I show you guys sometimes, yes, pictures of spirit around me. I was not normal. I cannot sit normal. I can't stay normal. You cannot be normal. See, you need to have some level of humanity to relate with people. I'm very serious. Suddenly, because then I began to meditate too much. I can stay and meditate for 7 hours. I sleep every day with my leg folded like this, facing up.
That's what I have to do at will to engage that time. I begin to go away. See, let me tell you, anything that God gives you and he doesn't control it, it will soon enter witchcraft. It's just a matter of time. You may start it very well in God, it will soon enter witchcraft. You may not believe me, but it's true. I didn't know when I had to go out and get all these Muslim child B to start staying in the sun to be counting him. I don't know when I did that. And I was praying in tongues too. I went to get Catholic own. I was just doing my best to ensure that anytime I call upon spirit, they will come and they will fly with me. From then, I can leave my body. I can literally be in my room. I'll pass through the wall and go out. I find myself in China, I find myself in India. I pray to people in the US, in the UK, in Hong Kong. Some of them will call me. Yes. When I come back, I'm tired. Sometimes I come back and literally it's as if my body is not holding myself again. It's trying to twist itself together. There was a day I was walking as well and I fell down. I just left. Sometimes I can be walking, walking as well in the day. But when you start engaging, when you start partnering with spirit, the problem is that they want to keep you in bondage. See, spirit bar are very lonely. They want to always have you around. So when you start giving them attention, I know the leader locked herself inside for 3 months with demons. She was talking with them, engaging with them. Very slowly, they start bringing her money, they start bringing her rings, they start bringing her gift. Physically now. I'm very serious. Spirit have you. They seek partnership. It's only the Holy Spirit that is concerned about how you can live well. All the other ones, they will use you and throw you away. It was not long enough. I realized that I was doing the wrong thing. I have to retract my way back so that I can live. Because sometimes I start going to other planet, Pluto, I will start seeing certain things. Hey God, it was strange. I begin to hear voices everywhere. Spirit talking to me everywhere. I can hear Leaf talk to me, Chair talk to me. Everything was just talking to me. You don't understand what I'm saying. You don't understand what I'm saying. See, there are certain realms of power. If you engage them at will, you may have problems. The Holy Ghost have to be your tour guide. If you can do your well, if you can do well, limit yourself to the Holy, because diverse voices can talk to you. Bible talk about that. There are many voices that speak and none of them is without significance. What did I tell you? None of them is without some kind of differences. It can do something. I know one of our friend then, prophetic friend then, that the time came, it became worse. That guy started picking prayer letter. Tell the Holy Ghost say she picked prayer letter. You tell the Holy Spirit say she sit down on the highway. Tell the Holy Spirit say she climbed this tree. That's madness. That can't be the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit says she pick chewing gum paper. The Holy Spirit says she did like this. That cannot be. See, you are being led by something. There are astral realms of oppressions. So in the bit of us to teach you to hear God, don't go and hear what is not God. You get what I'm saying? That's just what I want you to understand. Spirit transport is a healthy spiritual portion. If you read the book of Ezekiel, Ezekiel is one of the highest prophets that experienced spirit transport. You always see that he said, the spirit enters me and set me on my feet when he speak unto me. From then the spirit, you see, I was in the spirit. The spirit took him. He will take him to the ancient foundation of Israel. Sometimes you take him to a river full of dry bones, to a river, and begin to measure cubits, right? He was really taken in the spirit. Sometimes you take him to the temple of Israel, right? Sometimes you take him to a valley full of dry bones and you have to prophesy. Truly the spirit did that to people. I get it now. And we read about how Philip was taken from the Utopian Enoch to Azontos, right? But by the spirit, if you see the thing, you have to understand that the Holy Spirit did that to them. But many more times we do this thing at will, and that's why it becomes a problem. I don't know whether I get it now. So I include it to let you know that these things are real. Many more times we appear to people in their dreams. What do you think happens? It's spirit transport. Just that this one is just your spirit that appears. Many ministers that I honor from afar But I honored them to a point that they appeared to me at night. What do you think happened? It's their spirit that came. Do you get what I'm saying now? They can come by me, teach you and guide you and lead you ahead. I'm very serious. It's not a spirit transport. Because anytime you begin to advance in God, you come to a point where God can begin to borrow you. God can use you. When I can appear to somebody in his village and he'll pray, and the person can be healed and he'll come back. And I'm telling you the truth, in the village they will see him do a lot of things and it will be real. I don't know where I get it. I've had several times where people tell me that there was a guy that was scheduled for operation. Appendix operation, he was in the hospital, suddenly I appeared to the, in the hospital. And I came and I just prayed for him. And that's how he left the hospital. Till today, no operation. It happens. I know a lady, is it in Benue? Yes. She was in a relationship with one guy. And the guy died. And all of them are done all this kind of covenant. People used to do. Don't ever do that kind of covenant. Do covenant with God. Don't hold to human beings. You always break it. People, human beings break covenant. It's only God that when you break it, and then he will have mercy upon you. When she breaks this covenant, when the man, guy died, the guy keep appearing to her. Say, you to kill yourself so that you can marry in that other realm. And because she has already covenanted herself with that guy, he keep appearing to her on a daily basis. And because she's relating with spirit all the time, her blood, you know, spirit feed on blood, her blood begin to drain. She begin to have all kinds of sicknesses. Her spirit are responsible for every kind of infirmities. They took her to hospital, diagnosed her, she's dying, but they can't find any sickness. As she's in that hospital, she'll be seeing the guy riding in the car. He'll come and pass by her in the hospital. Sometimes he'll come and take her in the spirit to the graveyard, and they're going to stay together and they'll be talking. This girl is dying every day. She was confused and shouting in the hospital all the time, talking with somebody they cannot see. The doctors won't want to believe that one. They want something that they can put in report. When they call me, I speak with her. I say, well, the only thing I have to do is to talk to your guy. What was his name? She gave me his name. I use her doorway and I assess him. And I told him that she don't want to, because according to the law, to subvert a man against his cause, the law will not permit it. If he denounces a spirit, he's supposed to leave you normally. I'm very serious. If he denounces God now, if he, today I don't believe in Jesus again, I denounce, he's supposed to leave you. Because spirits are not supposed to force themselves. They need to have a partnership. That's why if you are possessed, you choose to be. If you remain like that, you choose to. You can choose to. Even if it is a pattern, we have educated you. You should know that you have a responsibility to do in breaking it. And that was how I had to talk with him. He told me, why will I bring myself in a case that doesn't concern? I said, well, she doesn't want you. Let her be. The guy refused. He said, he won't agree. Ha! That was when I have to invoke a weapon of war. I told him the next time he appeared to her, meet her, I'll appear with her. And both of us will jump together. If he's carrying her anywhere, meet her, I'll follow him. Like joke. As he appeared, I appeared. I want to carry her, I say lie. That's how we keep contending. Because then I can just lie down in my room for hours. I'm pondering, I'm meditating, and I'm everywhere. Meditation is terrible. I have to shut it down. I don't meditate like that again. It opens you. It opens you straight. What do you think yoga people do? What do you think they do? They harness energy and power. It's real. Serious. It's very, very real. Don't do it. Except if you can be guided into contemplative meditation with the word of God. I think the one of the word that was, you know, I was lying down. It was weird. I started having those encounters. But there's a limit and you have to be careful. Some certain thin line between all these things can lead you to what you can't contain. So that was how we were, and I struck him down. He left with a cry. Today she's free. Let me tell you, spirit transport is real. Some of us, if they come to kill us now, we will live here, we'll fly. Have you seen yourself in the dreams of time flying? I mean, you know this one is not occultic. You're actually really flying to certain places. It's true. It's part of it. I'm telling you the truth. And other times, when you see yourself in a place that you look as though you have been there before, it's actually you have been there actually before. Sometimes you can go to Lagos, and in a place, maybe like, it's as if I have been in this place. I have stood here and talked with certain people here. And now it's as though you are with them now talking it. Actually, you have been there before in the spirit. Because in the realm of the spirit, there is no past, present, and future. It's just now. That sometimes if you are seeing things, I was seeing something and I was telling the person something that I passed before. And the person thought I was lying. I said, well, that's the truth. That's what I actually seen. So spirit transport is real. I've been praying before. Okay, Roland did it now. So me, he was saying he went to somewhere. I believe he was presenting to one lady. Why? Something like that. And the prophet, that was what he did now. That he said that he went to a village or something like that. It was not you that he was saying that. You can be praying sometimes, but and suddenly you have a vision. You see yourself in a village, praying in a location. Or you see yourself praying in an altar or breaking something. What do you think really happened? Actually, you left yourself and you appeared there. But in the spirit, but your body is still here. Okay. If I say let's go to UK, London now. Some of you have already started picturing it already. You see how the thing works? Where's your spirit? Where's your soul? Show you a body that is limited. All the other ones are limitless. You can go anywhere. That's why anytime you enter a territory, you don't control the way your spirit goes. As you close your eyes, boom, you're in the spirit. That thing take another tour. And that's why personally people can't come back to their body again. They kill them there. So they can sleep and they can't wake up again. Why? Because man is spirit, soul and body. Any compartment that is kept in bondage will hinder the other ones from functioning. You can be disembodied spirit. The Bible says we wrestle against flesh and blood, but principalities, power, spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. One thing they call gods and ancestors. People that gave themselves, they remove their body and allow their soul and their spirit to become custodians over a region. So they keep certain boundaries in place. I'm very serious. So they guide the nature of everybody, the destiny of everybody in that village. When you want to rise, they appear to you. They say, no, nobody do this. No, nobody do this. So come and appease the gods. Appease them. Appease fire. Let me tell you. The same way that people can give themselves and become these entities, you yourself can have the ability to travel in the spirit. Wow. Can you add me maybe 10 more minutes so that I will give perspective to the non-cognitive way that God talks? All the ones I explain now are cognitive. That's intellectual. The one you can relate with your mind sometimes. The last one are the non-intellectual way that God speaks. Number one is stirring. Stirring. Many more times God will want to talk to you, but he will engage. See, these strings, it has to be. Please. Many more times when God wants to talk with you, he will stir you up. You can be in the class and you feel a stirring inside of you. So as a fire is burning somehow, God wants you to give it an expression so that he begin to talk. When you neglect it, when you quench it, you see, an unbeliever can grieve, can quench the Holy Ghost, right? A believer can grieve the Spirit of God. Anytime you hinder part of the non-intellectual speakings of God, you grieve the Holy Spirit. Sometimes the Holy Ghost will be stirring you to do something. So it's not convenient. That's why he won't talk. Evangelists sometimes can just be passing. Maybe where he used to pass, there is a cripple by there. Every day used to greet the person. One day as you just pass there, your hand just shake. Ha! When you leave here, nothing happened. You come back, you start shaking. You leave, nothing happened. You come back, start shaking. That's the right hand of God. At the moment, it's the right hand of power. Every day they have been passing through the gate, beautiful, one day. Say no. You just realize that there is something moving here. The Bible say at a specific time an angel come to stir up the pool. Anytime God stir you up, sometimes it's a call to an action. There is something that you wanted to do. Sometimes when I begin to pray, suddenly I will feel as though as if my head open, and it's as if they are pouring oil. Oh yeah, I will literally feel it too. When that start happening, my God, intuition, perception will switch. I'm telling you the truth. You start hearing word by force. Even when you don't want to hear, you hear. There are days when the thing become too much. If you can just respond, all you have to do is to answer one. If you respond to one, the other one will open. That's how the steering works. But you can neglect that steering. And when you neglect the steering, it will go like that. Like I said, it's not what you can relate with your mind. Another one is prompting. Have you been prompted before by God? Many more times God will prompt you into something. It will be instantaneous. You can be in the class and suddenly you don't feel like speaking in tongues. I say, people are in class, so what can I do? But at that moment, God was wanting to commune with you. But you deprive him that because you feel it's not convenient. You can be in a place and suddenly you are prompted to give something to somebody. You refuse. And do you know the funny part? It will be paining you. Hey! It's paining you. Because it was a prompting. Sometimes the only one can prompt you and say, pay this person transport. When you are going, you'll be waiting. Ha! Let me see whether this person has transport or doesn't have transport. Then he notices you wait whether he has it. He just says, pay it. I don't really get what I'm saying now. A prompting is a call. Sometimes it's like a call to duty for you to do something also. Then you can say, give this person this. If you obey that one, he can come and talk further. But if you disobey it, you have shut down that valve of communication. The universe can prompt you and say, cook food and give this person. You can't relate with it with your mind. But if you refuse it, anytime you see the person, it will judge you. Somehow, you feel, hi, God, I was supposed to do something. These are part of the patterns that you have to learn in your obedience with God. It's not the normal way that God taught, because you did not see a vision of you giving him food, that you didn't give him both. There was just a prompting. There was no voice anywhere. See, not all the time God uses audible voice to talk to you. Another one is burden. Burden. Many more times, many people used to have burdens, but they don't know why it's there. If you wake up at night and you cannot sleep, you wake up 2 o'clock, you can't sleep. You try to watch movie, you can't even watch the movie, don't enter your head. You try to play game for a year. Something was just heavy in your heart. It's God talking to you. Maybe your mother is about to die, and the Lord is looking for somebody that can stand in the gap at the moment, and he just prompted upon you and put the burden upon you. But you are trying to dilute it with movie, with games. And you know the funny part about this thing? If, for instance, somebody is sick and the Lord put the burden upon you to pray, you refuse to pray, when the person dies, you will cry. You feel as though you are the one that killed the person. The simple reason is this: because burdens is a call, deep call for intercession. And it's a preservative plan. The Lord prompted you and put a burden upon you to pray for your family. You refuse to pray until the day you find that your father is beating your mother. You are feeling bad. Why? Because actually you are the one that was supposed to stand in that gap at the moment. And that burden has been there. Learn to respond to burdens. Learn to respond to promptings. Learn to respond to stirrings. They may not be convenient, but they are part of the way that God talks to you. Some days you wake up with strange grace to fast. You don't even know why you don't want to eat food. You wake up and you are just, it's as if you are just crying. You are just worried. You don't know why you are worried, but you are just worried. It's a burden. Something may be wrong somewhere that you are the only one that can fix it. I'm telling the truth. You can try to distract yourself. Find a friend. Go here. Go here. It doesn't still go. Sometimes you try to pray, you cannot pray. You try to do, you cannot do it. It's just here. It's just there. Bear it. It's God talking to you. But sometimes God just shares his heart with you. The last one among the non-intellectual way that God talks is peace. That inner peace. Many more times you can be praying for a situation and God may not say yes, God may not say no, but he'll give you joy and laughter. Just know that this matter is settled. You pray for it again. It's peace that can help you to know what to pray and what not to pray. It will be wrong for, I don't know, mommy, I want to say to be wrong for all that you're praying for a private jet now. I don't think I need it now. No, I'm very serious. I can't maintain it. I get what I'm saying now. I'm not saying I will not have, I will not need it, no. But now, I don't need it. So if I pray, God will console me. Young man, rest. Stop praying now, man. Stop. Not very. You can be praying for your academics and God will say, you will just bring a peace for the exam. You know that, Kai, let the department get angry. You have, it is settled, God. Bible says, forever, oh God, your word is settled in heaven. That time when you just know that this one, God has settled it. Sometimes somebody can come and meet and say, pray for me, I want to travel, and you just hold the person's hand. I want to pray. You just felt a peace. You not see anything, so just go. Sometimes somebody come and meet you say, I want to do this business deal, I want to do this. As you just pray, there's this peace, this joy in your feet. Sometimes I used to check sometimes. If I have a dream, I check. Does it give me peace? Or does it take away my peace? Is there fear? Is there peace? I will know whether it's of God or it's of the devil. These are diverse ways that you can respond to God. Some of you may have been having the intellectual ways, the dreams, the vision, the revelation, the truth. Take them serious. So if you don't have a book that you write anything, your vision, your dream, you don't write anything, how can God keep talking to you? Bible says, write the vision and make it plain. I've never seen a great person that doesn't write. I mean, write in a book. I've never seen one. All of them write something. Because if what God is telling you means something to you, write it down. Say, that which I have shown you upon the mountain top, write them. If you want God to talk to you, have a table or have something that you want to write. He will talk. Be open. There is a saying that says, when the student is ready, the teacher will appear. And the Holy Spirit is always a teacher. He will teach you. He will lead you. He will guide you. And like I said, the voice of the Lord is in the realm. Call the Spirit. Nobody hear God from the natural realm. If you must hear God, you must learn how to gain access into the realm of the Spirit. You must learn how to switch your eyes, switch your ears, switch every of these your senses. They may be looking at you, but they are not here. If you don't know how to switch them, that'll be a very big problem. You may never hear God. You're going to be praying in a few minutes. And I trust God that as we pray, the Lord Lord God of Israel is going to begin to open your eyes. To them that will have visions, they will have visions. To them that will have trance, will have trance. To them that will have daydreaming, they will daydream. To them that will have revelations, they will have revelations. To them that will be prompted, they will have prompting. To them that will have peace of mind, they will have peace of mind. To them that will have inner witness, they will have inner witness. To them that will have inner knowings, there will be inner knowings. There will be intuitions, there will be perceptions. Many of you will be prompted by the Lord as you pray. Help me. Who was there? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Sbababula tanaku beratia tobala tashkebele tutere teba. Zibebuna tata tila baratun de keshkebele tiara rabaskotele betetua la rabaratun de kebeskele ataya. We call this a prayer conference. We're supposed to pray and sweat. I felt guilty that we did not pray. Not too guilty anyway. You see, your prayerlessness can limit God, I assure you. When Jesus was talking about prayer, he said, when you pray, not if you pray. Whether you like it or not, time must come that you will have to pray. It's just a matter of time. Believers need to be encouraged to pray. If you still need encouragement to pray, your journey is very long. I mean very, very long. Do you know that Muslims don't need encouragement to pray? Whether they have carryover, as long as they call that time of month, they will go and pray. Even if you are traveling with them, when time for prayer is, they will stop. If they are in the shop, when time of prayer is, they will close shop. Even if their father die, when it's time for prayer, they will close. You are the only one. Can you pray? Don't take us to where we don't know. I will need these things heavier. See, there are realms in God, there are dimensions in God. There are purpose in God. There are doors shut in my sight. But seven that my vision, I created a veil. I made me not to perceive the movement of God. Let that yoke be broken. Let the yoke be broken. Let the yoke. Let the yoke be broken. Oh God, grant me access to the realm of the spirit. The part right of all say, I was in the spirit on the last day. And I hear a voice. I don't know where you are. But that is the place of advantage called the realm of the spirit. Where you can hear a voice from behind. Saying this is the way, walk your way. Prayer is your access door. Prayer is your pattern of journey. Prayer. An investment in prayer profits so much. Oh God, open my eye. Oh God, open my ear. Oh God, let me be a lover. not be blind, I will not be deaf. I will not be blind, I will not be deaf. My eyes will see, my ears will hear.
You. Where is that guy? Oh God. Can you be more louder than him? I don't really know what you are playing. Where do you want to explain that time? I know. I'm just going to pray a simple prayer. That the eyes of your understanding be open. So that you can see, so that you can hear. I know you'll be more serious with God when you can hear and see. You want to sleep, suddenly you see. The day you are serious, you hear. Oh my God. Some of us cannot backslide again. As the thought come, another thought come again. I don't know how you help me with God. Can you close your eyes and talk to God? Don't be distracted. We are not here to educate your emotion. I don't want you to be emotional about it. I don't want you to be emotional. I've already told you that I know that after many years, not all of you will survive. I know. Don't just be the Judah. Don't be the Judas. All I say, you can be the son of perdition. Oh God. Die. That Jesus stood and said, none has been lost except. It's terrible. Can you close your eyes and talk to God? Close your eyes and talk to God and say, God, I have been blinded for so long. I have been deaf for so long. I have not been hearing for so long. You can be blind spiritually. You can be deaf spiritually. Tabalataya. Ask the Lord to open your eyes, open your ear. Salome ke batu ala da baya. Proto ko bakate balati ala ba balaka ba. Zele da kabakata na bakwada kabara de la kabata de la batay. Asiba bala na kabakata balati ya babalata babo. Zele ta kabata bula ta kabalati ya babalataya. Asha balata kabana basa blate bakate la kai. Rabada kabalata na babaka na mbali ya babalata na babalataya. Eleze bakabua la tabalata kai. Rabadala tamapana kababalati ya tababalataya. Zalele te baka ebotu alaka. Shabalata na bapana basta plata babalata na babalata. Elia tabaka mbote kabalati ya. Zabata kabala na nabapana kabali ya tababalata babalata. Elele bakanda babalata babuwa la babalataya. Zalela kanda na bashakrata kabalati ya babalataya. Rabale kabana bashabrata babalati ya. Elisa bana balata babulataya. The Lord be granted unto you visions. The Lord be granted unto you visions. The Lord be granted unto you visions. Visions, a restoration of dreams. A restoration of dreams. Many of you should have instructive dreams before. You can see the Lord is restoring that. The Lord is restoring dreams. The Lord is restoring prophetic dreams. Dreams that bring direction and guidance. The realm of vision. Father, I ask that you open the realm of vision. The realm of vision. In the name of Jesus, I pray. There are many that are here. I ask, oh God, Father, whether they have functioned in it before and it has ceased, I ask for a restoration. I pray that from today, let your eyes be open. Let there be visions like never before. I'm perceiving that there are people here that used to have actually dreams before. I mean, really prophetic dreams. Instructive prophetic dreams. But they have ceased. And eventually, because you have not been giving attention to them. But I perceive the Lord is going to be restoring them on mercy. So that you can begin to have dreams again that will be instructing you. You used to have dreams and it used to come to pass. You may instruct people before it comes. But all of a sudden you see the Lord is going to be restoring that. And to many of you, the Lord is going to begin to put burdens upon you. The Lord is going to begin to put burdens. You're going to begin to put burdens and you're going to begin to prompt you. And begin to stir up your spirit. So that there can be a calling into action. So that I can be calling into action. That you'll be neglecting the promptings. You'll be neglecting the stirrings. But Lord is going to be restoring that so that you can begin to engage them again. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And to many, there is going to also be an activation of your intuitions. The intuition and your perception. As a result of the atmosphere and the cloud, there is going to be an activation of your intuition and your perception. You're going to begin to have heightened level of perceptions. And understanding. Heightened level of perception and understanding. I have to perceive that word of knowledge is going to be sharpened. There's going to be increase in word of knowledge. Increase in word of knowledge. And I perceive that somebody has actually been functioning in the word of knowledge that has ceased before. Like you've been functioning, you okay? I don't know. Let me pray for you. I perceive the Lord is going to be restoring that. Not because he prayed for you, believe it or it will work. Right? Working in the word of knowledge before it ceased before. And I also see, like,
As I said, when the Lord is going to be sending you to secondary school, to secondary school to do evangelism there, actually you have that as an intention in your heart. Okay, you right? Please take it to heart. Right, take it to heart. And I see as you go there, there's going to be a massive outbreak there. I mean, a massive outbreak. And actually, it's as if they offer an invitation for you to come, something like that. Yeah, go. Go in the spirit and the power of the Lord. There's going to be massive outbreak in the name of Jesus. Because we actually begin to see visions of revival breaking out from secondary school. Because we don't know what is going on. The Lord is beginning to recruit young children into his army. Somehow, this is the time where that the Lord is beginning to put his voice upon the mouth of babes and sucklings. I mean, the voice of the Lord is beginning to be eminent amongst the babes and the sucklings in this season. Okay. So I perceive the Lord will be sending people within this region also. And I perceive a lady that used to have unusual menstrual flow. I heard the Lord said, I'm correcting that pattern. It has been prominent even among your siblings, and also even I think with your mother. The Lord said, I am correcting that in the name of Jesus. Shibatakule te birati na kapatu ana tabala shikepana tati na zibatatu te barati ya tabala tataya rabate kapala shabate kapunda bas kapula tani zibabatu la baba kwanda baria tababala tu la baba zabala bala katamba tabash kapula tababula taya akabatu le te baria tabala tabala tani zibabokoto pasigre te kepakoto balati ya tabala taya. The Lord is going to be raising a new prophetic breed of people. There will be a new prophetic breed of people. They are going to be an intertwined between the apostolic and the prophetic. This one will be giving revelation, insight, and also prophetic guidance. And the Lord is going to be raising this kind of army. They are going to be functioning without restraint. I won't be functioning without restraint, says the Spirit of the Lord. Unless I'm going to be causing a shifting in the sphere of influence within the campus, so that there's going to be a dethroning, because many people have occupied thrones of influence and they have not functioned appropriately. The Spirit of the Lord says, I'm going to be judging their operation and I'm going to dethrone them, so that many can be enthroned into their operation, says the Lord. Because that comes with a promotion, actually. That comes with a promotion. That comes with a promotion. Because I see people run and I see people transcending. And as well, Lord said, the promotion comes with a transition into a new kind of functioning. As well, Lord said, I should let you know that there is a shifting that has come upon the campus, so that men that have fulfilled the measure for the former season have been promoted into a new level of operation. And to others that are coming below will occupy their own vacuum, so that the vacuum created can now be occupied. Because many of them have left, created a vacuum that you have been unable to occupy. And the Lord said, I should let you know. The Lord said, I should let you know that it's going to be connecting the old voices with the new voices, so that it can bear a hybrid of functionality. So that the former impartation and the new impartation can join together and mix it up, so that a hybrid can be formed. So that with the new strategic wisdom for warfare can be initiated, so that men can be lifted through the warfare of advantage. But also see, like an increased contention upon the ointment, upon the head of many prophetic people. And the contention is to shut down their prophetic sight. And yet it's been not said that the prophetic will not be shut down, but it shall be sharpened again, so that it can be given penetration and access upon the front line. And the Lord said there's going to be accuracy and precision in the prophetic, especially in the campus. There's going to be an outbreaking of prophetic evangelism. There's going to be a part of prophetic evangelism. There's going to be an outbreaking. The heightened level of the functionality of the prophetic will come, so that the evangelistic can be effective, says the Spirit of the Lord. But I also see the Lord saying that there's going to be a pattern for intercession that is going to be initiated. And this pattern of intercession will involve the borrowing of the womb of the ladies. So the womb of the ladies shall be used for the birthing of the promises of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord said that there have been abortion of destinies. There have been abortion of promises. There have been miscarriages of them. Simply because there are no spiritual midwifery that can be able to orchestrate their delivery. The Spirit of the Lord said that an office of spiritual midwifery is going to be restored to the daughters of covenant, and this is going to come with heightened level of intercession. So many ladies will be called into depth functioning of intercession, so that their womb can begin to give vacuum for the expression of the promises of the Lord. And many will be given the wisdom to be able to be like the midwifery that are going to be helping others, for them to give birth to the promises of the Lord. Because without them, there's going to be a lot of miscarriages of the promises and the betting of the end time agenda of the Lord upon the campus. And I also see like a wildfire coming upon the campus. And so let's say I'm making University of Abuja to be like a hub, a prophetic and apostolic center, where which not just only the voice and the spirit of the Lord will be eminent, but men and women will be raised as leaders of influence upon the face of the earth. That's why Lord said that the campus has been locked down by the evil spell of the spirit of the bold woman. What I mean by that, he said, the Lord told you that. Well, it's, I'm reading from what I wrote. You see, the spirit of the Lord said that the campus has been laid down by the intercession and the speakings of the spirit of the born woman. It was part of the foundation laid down upon the campus, and it was proclaimed as an ordinance that the campus will not be an equipping center, that the campus will not be a crucible, and that every voice that seeks to rise is shut down, because diverse kind of patterns are being opened, so that the limitation and the hindrance can be eminent, and people see nothing but weakness. But here the Lord said, I'm empowering your strength. Lord said, I'm empowering your strength. And by the spirit of the apostolic and the guardianship of the prophetic, you shall soar through, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord will also have to restore the office of spiritual motherhood. It has been lacking. There have not been mothers sufficient that will understand the burden upon the ladies. And the Lord say, I'm raising ladies that are faithful and committed and dedicated to come into the office of spiritual motherhood. So lacking unto Deborah arise to be a mother in Israel. So many ladies shall receive the impartation and the visitation that can cause the habitation to become mothers upon the campus. So this one shall have excellent wisdom for legislation. This one shall have excellent wisdom for administration. This one shall have excellent wisdom for counsel. The Spirit of said, I'm restoring unto them again weapons of warfare, so that they can conquer through within them, that they might conquer through others. I heard the Lord say that I will put them upon the front line, and they shall be part of the army that I will raise. So they shall be part of the warriors. They shall be part of the warring prince that I will raise, says the Spirit of the Lord. I'm just hearing the Lord is saying that he's collecting somebody respiratory condition. I don't know, you have a respiratory condition, something that has to do with respiration, breathing. The Lord is correcting that in the name of Jesus. That's why Lord said that I'm going to cause many to initiate a covenant with me of the supernatural. And many upon the campus, say this campus will be opened by the supernatural manifestation of the Lord. So this is going to confuse them. So it's going to confuse them. There's going to be heightened supernatural manifestation, sudden supernatural manifestation. That's why Lord said the revival that is going to come upon this campus is going to come with supernatural manifestation, unending supernatural manifestation. But many shall be caused to initiate that covenant. But the circumcision for that covenant is going to involve their blood. It's going to cost you a lot. You're going to be circumcised again after this new order of covenant of priesthood. And with that will come the spirit of the daring faith upon you, so that you can begin to function with the faith of the Son of God. Now let's not say that fresh encounters shall be caused upon people. I mean fresh encounters and fresh visitation. The Lord said that I should let people know that everybody should find his prophetic placement in him in time, else you'll be eluded by the judging rulers of the throne of God. The Lord says he doesn't want wasted people. He says everybody needs to be placed aright. Everybody must understand his boundaries of operations, his jurisdiction of sight. Because I see a shaking coming upon the campus. next season will come by a shaking that will take away the former things. And also you see a storm that rises, a heavy storm that is rising upon the believers upon the campus. There's going to be an outbreak of backsliding like never before. Sorry, it's a bad thing to say. Why possible? Many people are getting ready. Promises of God have not been coming. Answers have not been coming. Many people are going to backslide. That's why you are here. To get the wisdom that will guide you, as Roland said. I also see many people begin to bear fruit. They begin to bear fruit. They begin to bear fruit. The pursuit have not produced result. I see sudden result and fruit begin to be beared. I see a vision of a lady like a lady that covers a nation. I spell Lord say, I'm making you a mother unto nation, that you'll be shown visions of nations. And you'll be praying and interceding for nations. I swear Lord said that I'm gonna make you a voice unto the nation. You saw that vision? You saw it? Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for that ordination in the name of Jesus upon you. I swear Lord said, I'm gonna give you a voice unto the nation, that you're gonna be consolation unto the nation. Yes, and also see a lady that you've been abused before, actually. You've been abused before, like you've been raped before. And that's what Lord said, that He's going to comfort you so that you will have the wisdom to be able to comfort others. The Lord said He's going to put the burden upon you to help ladies that have actually been abused before. Okay. But somehow, yes, I begin to see, like, the way I see is different from the way Roland see, right? I told you the apostolic work with intuition. You see, I have to read from the one I have written. You have to write, because sometimes as an apostolic person, when you are walking, the Lord will tell you. I get what I'm saying now. Roland can just come and just God, that one happened to me a few times. I think the last meeting happened, right? That was good to. Yes. I also saw like a restoration of the heritage of somehow. I saw as if there were men that labor. I'm not talking about them Toby and Roland. It's as if I saw people that truly, really pray in this land before. I'm very serious. I saw like ancient fathers that were praying and interceding in this land. I get what I'm saying now. And the Lord says it's going to cause encounters. You're going to begin to have, many people are going to begin to have encounters with certain elders. And they're going to tell you that they were actually from this land. And this is what I'm saying now. That they have labored, and the promise of what God promised them, they did not receive it. I don't know why you get what I'm saying now. They're going to come and appear to you and going to pray for you and connect you to the ancient heritage. So that with that, you're going to now begin to have the impartation of the old and the new. That will cause the hybrid functionality. Does that even make sense? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And so, Father, we pray with us, O God, that whosoever is here under any bondage and patterns that is not of God, may that you be broken. We come against every curses in the bloodline. We come against every ordinations and ordinances that are not according to the pattern of God. Let them break in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that no one here that is under this cloud and under this atmosphere that has been prayed for will return back with a pattern that is not of God. Father, I pray, oh God, that may you elevate everyone above the limitation of their family. I pray, oh God, that that which nobody has ever done in your family, you will do it. The devil will be hopeless in your situation. Father, we pray, oh God, that may this our waiting be a sacrifice that will be recognized in the realm of the spirit. We pray, oh God. Father, you said that you are going to number many that are going to bear influence upon this campus. I pray that this quorum, these ones, let everyone here be sealed. Let everyone here be sealed in the name of Jesus. I pray that every pattern be broken. I ask, oh God, now, oh God, you that deliver men, I pray, find a way and deliver everyone. Grant unto us wisdom, wisdom like never before, that we may navigate the patterns in the family. Father, we pray, oh God, that we will not be ignorant of the devil's devices. We pray that your grace will rest upon us. Your spirit will be powerful upon us. None of us will backslide. None of us will be son and daughter of perdition. We pray that none of us will be once upon a time anointed. Father, I pray that you keep us. You keep us in the name of Jesus. Unto him that is able to keep us from falling, and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Unto the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power from now and forever. Amen and amen. There was no need to do prayer. I think we have all our prayer. Pray. You will see one person that prayer again. Ha! No. This way.
Hallelujah. I'm sure we're blessed. So can you say a word of prayer? Just whisper to the Holy Ghost. We fill him with virtue. Virtue has gone out of him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' name we've prayed. Okay. Tomorrow we'll be meeting in multiple places. Near that place they do collect school fees.